So here are some impulsive compulsive disorders that are not related to addiction, but are behaviors. Now, OCD used to be in the chapter on anxiety, but it's got moved out. Here we're going to mention it, and OCD related disorders are mentioned here. So OCD has some worry, but it's really obsessions is the type of worry. You're obsessing about things, and anxiety and fear that about your obsessions are there, and compulsions are ritualistic behavior. That's what OCD is, obsessions and compulsions. And in addition to OCD, you have ICD. At least this is not necessarily everybody agrees with this, but you can have impulsivities in the lots of disorders. Agitation and Alzheimer's disease, you'll hear in the lecture on Alzheimer's disease that there are at least two new therapies in progress for agitation in Alzheimer's disease. We will hear in the ADHD chapter that the stuff that helps your cognition and your inattention also helps your motor and behavioral impulsivity. It's called stimulants. Provocative behaviors in mania are reduced by treatments of mania. Disruptive mood regulation disorder is a new and somewhat controversial kind of diagnosis in children, pyromania, kleptomania, paraphilias, etc. Many of these have treatments that work for, like say in Tourette's syndrome for the tics, but it also works for some of the impulse control. So these are very interesting disorders in their own right. And you have more of them listed here. Even borderline personality disorder could be seen in many patients as an impulse control disorder. Some of them, of course, do self-harm, and sometimes the self-harm becomes very compulsive and very difficult to treat. If any of you have seen patients like that, like in state hospitals and in forensic hospitals. And aggression and violence could be a form of an impulsive disorder. It's controversial. But there is very quickly one slide on this. We have a whole book on this. I've studied this with colleagues at the state hospitals and written books on this. But psychotic violence is only 20% of all the violence in a state hospital system. Psychopathic, which is the type where you actually lie in wait and plan it and do it from a sociopathic and manipulative way, is only about 17%. Most of the violence is impulsive, which means something in the environment triggers me to hit a nurse or hit somebody else in the hospital. And so that needs to be treated by getting the underlying disorder generally in control.